Hi guys, so I'm back today with a project share. So this is a project that I've been working on. It is for a swap that I joined over at myscraproom.ning.com, and it was the loaded envelope. So this is the project that I created. The paper that I used was KaiserCraft Silver Bells, so it was from last year's Christmas release, and then I used a lot of glitter paper. So I drew my inspiration and the items that I made from another YouTuber, and I'm trying to remember the name of it. I will try and remember to link her down below, and that way you guys can see her beautiful creation. I didn't copy them exactly, but I did just keep track of the items that she did, and then I, you know, kind of made the same items. So without further ado, I'm going to go ahead and show this. So the outside, I made out of white cardstock, and I inked it in the Distress Ink Spun Sugar. The paper, I matted all the way through, and I'll show you it a little bit better when I get there. And then on the back, I used one of the Cherry Lynn Design dies and cut it out of the silver shimmer paper, and then put the swap information on the back from some more of the pattern paper. And then I trimmed everything in this really it's a braided trim, and this is from Michael's. I don't remember the brand of it, but this is the pink version, and they had a pink, a silver, and also a blue, and I picked up one of each because those were the colors in the pocket, the envelope that I made. This is for Penny, and Penny doesn't have a YouTube that I know of, and when I was talking with her, I asked her, would you rather have Christmas or would you rather have winter? And I actually gave her a couple of different paper collections to choose from. It was Sweet Peppermint, this one, the Silver Bells, and Prima's Vintage Christmas from last year. But she chose this one. So my colors are based off of the pink and also the blue. So let's go ahead. So this is a little, the poinsettias are from a Brenda Walton die, and it's her fancy poinsetta, I think. If I remember, I'll try and link it down below as well. And then this is just a piece from the Ephemera collection. It's just a Merry and Bright thing, and I actually have it here. It's from the collectibles, so it's the cardstock pieces, and I've used quite a bit of these. Okay, so first and foremost, I made a couple of rosettes, and I picked up some clothespins, and I covered them in this one. I think is Silver Shards, or what is it called? I have it right here. This is the Recollections Shred Glitter. And so what I did is I just covered it in the glitter, and it's a white clothespin. I used, this is the rosette itself is a cut from my Cameo, and I used a Recollections punch. I don't know the name of this punch, but this is the punch I used for this one. And this is a little yellow bicycle bow die. So I just did that for that. Where's the other one? So this one is almost identical. Actually, I think they are identical, except I used a different punch for this one. And this is a Martha Stewart punch, and I don't remember the name of this one, but I just love that punch, so I made that one. And then I made one more rosette clip, and this one's a little bit different. I used some Recollections glitter and just in the silver, and I coated the clothespin with it. I did the same rosette. But on this one, again, I used a different one. This is a EK Success punch, and I don't know the name of this one either, but that's what this one looks like. I think this is something fanned scallop or something like that. I don't know. used some of the leaves from the Brenda Walton die, and then also made a poinsettia out of pink glitter paper. So those are the three clothespin rosettes that I created. This is a little shaker paper clip, and I filled it with the glitter shards and some iridescent, sorry, there's a train, and I had something in my eye, and again, I still have something in my eye. Hopefully that train isn't too loud. So this is a cut from my silhouette, and I just shrunk this down and cut a circle in the center of this particular cut. Actually, this one might have already been a picture frame, and so I actually cut several layers of cardstock on this one and just glued them all together and made a shaker. And I repeated the process in pink. So there's a pink and there's a blue one. This is a ornament that I made, and let's go ahead and zoom in here, guys. So this ornament right here is a silver snowflake that I got from Recollections, and it's just silver glitter snowflake. I created another rosette out of my pink shimmer paper, and then these are just little bits of evergreen bough or evergreen pieces. I don't even know what you'd want to call that. Stuck behind this is just a little collectible ephemera piece, and then there is, I found this piece in my stash. It's just a pink kind of gem spray, I guess is what it's called, all kind of layered together, and then it is on some pink and white baker's twine, and I just thought that was super cute. Now going into this, so I made some packaging. Now this particular piece has little tags from the collection and then some more dies from that bow die, but I created more bows and then they'll just need to be fluffed up. I also cut some pieces out of silver glimmer, or you know, glimmer paper and or shimmer glitter, whatever you want to call it, and also some vellum from their cuts from my silhouette, and then I added a couple of the tags themselves. Also a couple of toppers pre-punched, and then some cellophane bags so she could make her own package like this. The only thing I didn't add was some of the washi, and that's because I don't have a really good way to do washi for, you know, individual packaging kind of thing. So again, made another little bag with that pretty scallop punch, another bow, and then another tag, and then I just put in some really, some pieces from the collectibles ephemera pack. I think that's it. Yep, that's it in that one. Then I created three tags. Now I used the Tim Holtz tag, and what I did was the first, I put these in plastic bags because this glitter does come off a little bit. I tried to seal it as much as possible. This is a little star piece from Michaels, and with this it actually was gold and silver, but I wanted it totally silver. This is just a piece of beautiful trim or flower pieces that I had in my stash, and here's another one that I didn't use. And then, so I cut the tag out of just white cardstock, inked all around the edges using the pink sponge sugar. This, and then matted the glitter paper. This is a little journaling card from the collection. Some trim from my stash, and it just matched beautifully the silver. And then this right here is from the $1.50 Michaels, and they're just wood pieces, and what I did was I just glittered them again using the Recollections silver glitter. So I made this one, and sorry if there's a glare, I'm trying to get rid of that glare. There's glare. And then the trim is just trim from my stash. It's just some eyelash fibers and things like that. So there's that one. This one slightly different because it's got some blue in it. And then this one says Happy Holidays. So it's all the same layout. It's just different wording with a different card. And then this one is really pretty. This is Peace, Love, and Joy. Okay. So that takes care of that. Then I created two wands. And I'm going to tell you guys, before I saw the video of the gal who I took inspiration from as far as the items go, oh my gosh, I didn't even know what a wand was. I am so out of the loop. So just some silver straws from Michael's. And then I created a large rosette. So here's a large rosette. Another little poinsettia piece, some eyelash trim. And then these swirls right here are cut from more glitter paper, obviously, but they are from the Brenda Walton die. This is just a little ephemera piece, and so is this. And with the Santa, I just, there's a little doily piece behind him from the ephemera collection. You can kind of see that. But what I did was I glued those down, and then I popped up the Santa on the eyelash trim. This is a little just piece from my stash. I don't remember where it came from, but it's just a little glittered snowflake. And then this little piece right here is just, again, from the ephemera piece, and I glossy accented it. So there's the wand. The back of it I covered with more silver glitter paper. And this one is very much the same, except I did it in an oval. Now, again, this is a cut from my silhouette. Both of these are cuts from my silhouette, but I used different border punches. So this one, again, I used that scalloped kind of scallop. And same process with this one, except I used two poinsettias, some more eyelash trim, and then these again are they're the same swirls, they're just in a different color. Another ephemera piece, and then this also, but this one again I glossy accented it. So there is the wands. Now inside, no, there's a little bow right there to kind of cover it, but I also attached with an eyelet some, some eyelash trim, and then I strung some jingle bells from the end. So inside, there is a ton in here. So again, more packaging, and I created four little rosettes, and I put poinsettia flowers on them with silver leaves, and so they're super sparkly, super shiny. And they're all attached to acetate with just glue dots. The next one is a set of six roses that I created. So this is a die, a Spellbinders die that I used. And what I did was I rolled them, glued them all together, and then dipped the edges in glue and then glittered them. So some of the glitter does come off on this. So just a heads up, there's a little bit of glitter that comes off. Then I created six bow dies from the little yellow bicycle die, and I just assembled them and put them in a package. And then this is 12 hand-tied bows. Now, I'm not the best at tying bows when it's one-sided ribbon, but I did the best I could, and I think that they're cute, and they can go on, you know, many different projects. This is just a bag of kind of shaker bits that I created using just sequins from my stash, so they're all kind of coordinating colors. Then is that okay? One more thing in here. I created this envelope using my envelope punch board and some vellum, and then what I did is I embossed it. I just thought with my my snowflake embossing powder, and then I created these little four by four shaker bag cards. And so there's the shaker bits in there, and then there's the piece of like the greeting, and then on the back she can actually write on the back if she wants to. I was going to create, because these actually fit in there really perfectly, I was going to create an envelope for each of these, however I only have the one piece of that vellum, so it fits in a standard A2 size card. This is, or actually it's a little bit, I don't know. So same thing with this one. And I just love kind of how these turned out. And you just kind of shake them. So there's that. And that's all that's in there. So quite a bit in there. And I just think it turned out really, really pretty. I'm going to back this out so you guys can kind of see the full thing with the silver poinsettias and then the pink flowers behind it. And just kind of the whole thing. So I trimmed everything out in that braided trim. So thank you guys so much for watching. And I will see you guys next time. Bye.